Hi Founder fans, Jason here. Today we're going to be discussing that time that the Continental Army marched thousands of British soldiers across the colonies. Specifically, we'll be focusing on a founder whose name was Theodorick Bland. Side note, Theodorick is a great name. The founders had some great names. Anyway, Theodorick Bland was a nephew of Richard Bland, who I'll talk about in another time, but basically was one of the older gentlemen who led the men who would be founders into the revolution, but Richard passed away very early on in the conflict. Theodorick Bland had gone to Europe and studied as a physician, returned home, but was a very sickly man. He was never really well, so he didn't follow his initial trade. He ended up just running a plantation, as Virginians were wont to do. Now, he was friendly with George Washington, and Bland was an avid horseback rider. So Washington recruited Theodorick Bland to put together a cavalry, and it ended up becoming the 1st Continental Cavalry. He served for several years, and then after the Battle of Saratoga, the British, a huge section of the British Army, were captured. And what they did is first, Major General William Heath took over and brought these prisoners to Boston, just outside Boston. And the British prisoners became known as the Convention Army. It wasn't really an army, it was a captured army, is a better way to say it. But they soon realized that being outside Boston was a terrible place for these prisoners, because they could just escape into the city. So Theodorick Bland was given the tall order of taking the Convention Army and transporting it 700 miles south on foot to what today would be Central Virginia. So he did this, and even though hundreds of prisoners did escape along the way, his movement was actually considered a success, because he was able to get thousands of prisoners 700 miles on foot. Now, shortly after this, Bland did decide, you know what, this... He was always sickly, as I said, and he decided, I need to retire, I need to resign. Like, I can't keep up this pace anymore. So he goes back home. A few years later, he's elected to the Virginia Convention, called to ratify the Constitution. And Bland, as many Virginians did, Bland was actually against the Constitution and voted against it. Even so... It passed, as we know today, and the United States government was created, and Theodorick Bland was voted in as an inaugural member of the United States House of Representatives, where he went to New York, and he served for 15 months when he got his sickness finally caught up to him, and he passed away at about 49 years old, and he has the dubious honor of being the first sitting member of the United States House of Representatives to die. So that, in a nutshell, is the life of Theodorick Bland, an interesting founder to say the least, who, as far as I'm concerned, has a very unique position of marching the biggest swath of British captured soldiers in probably American history, unless there's something in the War of 1812 I'm not aware of, but I doubt it. So anyway, if you like this video, please hit like. If you're just passing through and you stumbled onto it, please subscribe. I tell stories like this 5 days a week, and I hope you enjoy them. For now, this is Jason signing off. You have a great afternoon, and I will talk to you tomorrow.